How humans helped cats to take over the world. Before we start, I would want you to hit that red subscribe button so that you never miss out on any of our videos. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Animal Kingdom. Here are how humans helped cats to take over the world. Cats have mounted a silent takeover of the world. They are in backyards, on t-shirts, and motivational posters, and let's not even talk about the internet. Now, a new study from a team of international researchers has determined how they managed to do it. Through humans. Researchers from the University of Leuven in Belgium, France, National Center for Scientific Research, and the University of Paris Diderot wanted to figure out when and why we've let felines let into our lives, rather than keep them outside as pest control. They studied the DNA of more than 200 cats from the past 9,000 years, including mummified Egyptian cats and ancient Romanian cats from the Mesolithic era. They found that cats spread around the world at two times. One, due to farming practices, the other as trade routes began to open. But it was the Egyptians who made cats into the domesticated gods they are today. At some point, cats evolved this more friendly disposition to humans, so they went from pest control agents to pets. Claudio Ottomi, co-author of the paper published in the journal Nature, Ecology, and Evolution, told CBC News, "Those that were more friendly were those that were more easily kept by humans. Thousands of years ago, as humans began to farm, wild cats likely crept into human settlements, finding it rich with food, mainly in the form of mice and other vermin. And as it turned out, this was highly convenient for humans as well, as these four-legged balls of fur were keeping mice out of seed stores and didn't seem to be much bothered with humans. Some might say this hasn't changed all that much." This mutually beneficial relationship helped to cement the cats in everyday life, the researchers said. While all domesticated cats stem from Felis silvestris libica from the Near East, a region that extends from Libya to Afghanistan, there are five distinct subspecies. This new research suggests that two of these subspecies led to the domesticated cat we are familiar with today, one from Southwest Asia and the other with an African lineage. The Southwest Asian cat shows up 9,000 years ago in Turkey, and clearly humans did more than tolerate them. The cat appears in the Mediterranean region around 6,500 years ago, likely following migrant farmers. From there, it spread around Asia, Africa, and the rest of Europe. Then there's the Egyptian cat. Around 5,000 years ago, Ottoni said it was clear that this cat began to be seen as more of a companion than a pest killer. Egyptian art depicts it sitting on sofas and around tables, clearly as part of the family or just refusing to move. As well, Egyptians began to mummify the cats just as they did humans. These Egyptian cats also hitched a ride with Vikings on their expeditions, and their population exploded around the world. By then, cats had already made their way into human lives and come indoors. There was a sort of switch, some kind of change in the behavior of cats, which occurred in the Egyptian cats that made them more appealing, Ottoni said. This change was probably mostly in their behavior. Cats became more tolerant of humans, more friendly, and that kind of opened the doors to the domestic fireplace, in a way, and humans began to appreciate them as companions and pets, like the pet that we know today in our households. Researchers also decided to look at patterns on cats. Around 10,000 years ago, the Libica cats were sandy-colored and striped, but today, we look around and see cats of various shades and patterns. This occurred as cats spread around the globe, intermingled and bred. In a separate analysis, the researchers found that the tabby cat, with its distinctive mottled appearance, occurred during the Middle Ages. By the 19th century, however, breeding begins to become more popular and different coat patterns emerge. So why do we continue to love the clawed, moody furballs even as they may annoy us, weaving in between our legs as we walk? There is an intimate relationship between humans and cats, Ottoni said. It's really a sort of bond. It's that made cats so successful around so many places. And so with that, we have come to the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed watching it. What do you think about how humans help cats take over the world? Let us know your views in the comment section below. And until the next video, stay tuned and subscribe to our channel for more uploads like this one. Also, if you're not subscribed yet, then do it now. Otherwise, you will miss out. See you soon and goodbye.